This past Monday in Zimbabwe, a 21-day deadline to exchange old banknotes for new ones with three fewer zeros expired. We all have a vague idea what's happening in our northern neighbor, but what do the statistics mean on the ground?
Zimbabwe is no longer a nation of poor millionaires. This week, the Reserve Bank introduced new currency with three zeros removed from the unwieldy denominations. Now shoppers don't need trolleys of money to buy a few groceries. And Zimbabweans had 21 days to change their old money or lose it. There were long queues as people scrambled to exchange their savings before the money became worthless on Monday. Operation Sunrise was launched by Reserve Bank Governor Gideon Gono to get local currency into the fold and curb the world's highest inflation rate of 1,200%. During the three-week grace period, individuals were restricted to deposits of $100 million a day. Any extra cash was confiscated, as the police, army and youth brigades held roadblocks in a blitz that the state claims netted about 35 trillion old Zimbabwe dollars.
Overnight, the whole nation was turned into a criminal unless it proves itself innocent if we are found with money in excess of 100 million.
There are numerous allegations from people too scared to appear on camera of their savings disappearing into the pockets of the militia.
Everybody is scared of the police and the army.
2 weeks ago, Veronica, not her real name, was on her way to buy groceries when she encountered a roadblock.
And I said to my son, I said, shit, this is what I really hate about this place. You know, roadblocks at every single robot looking for money. The officer that stopped us, he went and wrote a statement for me saying that I said bad things about Zimbabwe and I also said bad things about Mugabe, which I did not do.
She was arrested for provoking peace and only released after paying a bribe. Cosmetic changes to the currency have done nothing to alleviate the plight of the poor. In fact, ordinary people bore the brunt as many shops cashed in on the confusion, raising their prices.
They are making life for people to become more harder and harder.
Most Harare residents live in sprawling slums on the outskirts of the city. Josephine and her son share a house with eight other families.
These are the new notes we are here for. Don't buy anything except a sweet. One in nigga sweet.
So life is hard for us to continue just to live like wild animals.
Josephine and her friend Rufin depend on their families for food.
People have had to forgo a number of their meals. You'll have to choose whether you eat in the morning or you eat in the evening or not eat at all, depending on your circumstances.
Life is impossible.
Our kitchens are very empty. Even the cockroaches, there are nothing to eat. We can't afford to live. Everybody's not happy. We might smile, but we are very, very angry.
Operation Sunrise comes in the wake of Operation Marumba Tswina, a brutal cleanup campaign launched in May last year. Authorities destroyed illegal structures, razing whole shantytowns. In many cases, people were forced to demolish their own homes. According to a UN report, the operation left about 700,000 homeless and affected a further 2.4 million people.
So far now, our life is very hard.
Among the ruins of their houses destroyed by Marumba Tswina, these people, who eke out a living hawking vegetables, are living in makeshift shelters. They remain vulnerable to the elements and harassment from the police.
Yeah, I feel pity for that, but hey, no anything to do.
Both campaigns have been especially hard on the informal sector. Marumba Tswina saw markets destroyed and thousands of hawkers arrested. Before the 21st, a litre of Coke cost $500,000. Now it's a more manageable $500, but that hasn't stopped runaway inflation. In 2003, a packet of carrots cost $1,000. In April this year, they cost $33,000. 4 months later, it's a whopping $354,000. A basket of groceries that cost $3 million in April had doubled in price last week. 2 days later, half the items had increased in price again, adding 853 new currency dollars to the bill. On Tuesday, when the old notes were scrapped, there was chaos at the tills. A shortage of small notes left many shoppers short-changed. In the early days of liberation, Zimbabwe's future looked bright. But today, a third of the population needs food aid, and the bankrupt treasury can't afford to import desperately needed food or fuel.
And the government needing a lot of money and finding it very difficult to get more taxes from a shrinking economy, they have started to print money.
The decline of agriculture, the chief source of foreign exchange, has meant a massive loss of jobs and government revenue.
Government has literally looted the savings in our pension funds and our own bank deposits. Because the savings have gone, they are forced to print even more.
And so inflation gathers momentum, and with unemployment at 80%, things fall apart.
Issues of electricity, the water, school fees, people cannot afford medicines, the infrastructure in the hospitals has collapsed.
Because of corruption.
Those with the right connections continue to acquire land and assets using their access to subsidized grain, foreign exchange and fuel.
People have never been this wealthy in the history of Zimbabwe. The houses that they are building in some of the areas, the number of cars that they drive.
But they can make up different rules which benefit them enormously.
We asked for a response from the Zimbabwean government, but none was forthcoming. He also announced an imminent sequel to Operation Sunrise that he said would be short and swift. But Finance Minister Herbert Murawa has warned that those three zeros could be back on the notes as early as December.
After several years of very rough treatment, the population, I think, is very intimidated. But everything has its limits, and I suspect that the government is rapidly approaching the limits of people's patience right now.